Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, and I'm a lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam. Here I'm going to tell you what is happening in the world. And this age is called Kalyug in India, or the Dark Age, because there's no religious light. The Brahman, the men, to whom this duty was imposed by the prophet Moses and also Ram Chander, they had become corrupt, greedy, money, cheat, and they floundered the law as they liked it, and nobody was there to question them. They made the people deaf and dumb, not to speak. In India it was so that if a person of Shudra Varna, the once born, if he utter the holy book verses, then he should be caught, mortal lead should be put into his ears. That means such was the control of the Brahmins in India, and same in the Middle East. So here are something written about the four ages, and hope you will try to understand, because the gospel is by the grace of our Supernatural Father. Nobody can give you. So I have written a book, and in which I have tried to explain these four ages too. And this is the thing. This is the kingdom of rabbis, and that is same thing, you know. You need to have salt, truth, contentment, and mercy. And mercy is the chief quality of our Supernatural Father, light of our God. So no mercy, no light of God. Because if you possess all these, then you represent our Supernatural Father, which we call Al-Rahim, the greatest merciful person. That's why Jesus performed merciful deeds without asking any question to the person. Those who long to have mercy, he gave them the mercy. Those who did not, he did not. So this is the Dark Age. And this is the Dark Age of the heart and not of the books. So our covenant with Christ Jesus is not of the Bible, but of the Holy Spirit, and which is here. The book finished here, John the Baptist. Luke 16, verse 16. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. So in the university, they are teaching them the books, Old and the New Testament. The university professor, they are themselves super donkeys carrying holy books, and so they make their disciple super donkey with degrees, PhD, doctorate of this and that. And I live near Oxford University, and I go there to listen to their seminar. And sometimes I ask them simple question, in whose name John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water and Christ Jesus? Or why John the Baptist never baptized a woman, a Gentile, or a Samaritan? They have no idea at all. And they won't, I told them I can give you seminar. They won't let me because I have no degree in theology. I was attending New Testament seminars in Oxford University, what's his name, Kigley College or something, you know. So they told me that I can't come to their seminar, because I don't have a MA or PhD degree in theology from the university. a letter of recommendation from the Doapar blind priest in the church. So that is there. So I called them super donkey carrying holy books, and they retorted that our duty is to teach the dead letters of the Old and the New Testament. The interpretation is up to the student, which is right. Interpretation comes by the grace of our supernatural Father. But being drunk with the old wine, they desire not the new. I try my best to tell them a New Testament professor. I told him the names of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman. She was Saint Fortina, and he called her that she was a sinner, marrying one husband after the other. So, such are the super donkeys. And they are the one who get Nobel Peace Prize in religion. Sugar-coated sermon, shame on them. So, here is something I have written, and Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in my native language Punjabi we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells within his most beautiful living temple. This is not dead, living temple of God, capable of thinking and all that, intuition, created by the greatest artist, demiurge potter, the lord of the nature. Potter, he created all that, this human body, this body was created by Yahweh. Very beautiful. Nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, same name, you know, different name, same person, demiurge, lord of the nature. And it is called Harmandir. Har means God, Mandir means temple, or Emmanuel, God is with us. If you have no blood money in your system, you haven't cheated anyone, then God is in and Satan is out. Otherwise, if you are cheating people, taking bribe, then Satan is in and God is out. Simple as that. You cannot know Christ then. So here is a, according to Christ Rajinder, my name is, first name is Rajinder, my surname is Nijjar. But in God, no family names. I become just Rajinder, and no family name. Sadhus don't have tribal identity. Their tribal identity implicit, not explicit. It's only in the below we have explicit. So that's why Jesus said below and above, you know. In above, what we speak, we know what we are saying. We don't need book, because we think logically, and logically we explain. My brother, there are four religious qualities, and they are Haumae. Haumae, in Punjabi we are speaking, Haumae means ego. Ego-dominated people, you know, are honest, like Peter, but he full of ego, you know, like Peter, that once born, but once born, they are once born people, like little children. This Yug was Doapar. Doapar is having two qualities. One was the salt, our conscience. The other was truth. Two of them. That is what called do mean two, upper mean the age. Then the second one is man. या फोर स्पिरिचुअल स्टेट होमे मन बुद्धि चित. सो मन अंडर मन मीन द माइंड इट इज कॉल्ड नफ्स नफ्स एंड दिस नफ्स लाइक द वर्ल्डली थिंग्स वर्ल्डली टेस्ट वॉन्ट टू रूल ओवर द वर्ल्ड एंड ऑल दैट मटीरियल थिंग ही लाइक्स नॉट हिज स्पिरिचुअल एंड जुडा इस्कारियोट वाज stealing money from the purse, such people. So this is the age of that people, cheating people. So Kalyug we call it. So man called Nafsani, in Arabic they called Nafsani man. Clever people, they won't You clever psychic people, you can't blame them. If anything goes wrong, they will blame you, not themselves. Man, Nafsani, clever people as the rabbis, Brahmins, mullahs, etc. are today. You can't blame them, you know, they will blame you rather than themselves. In Kalyug, Kalyug means this is the age. Kal means famine, Yug means the age. Age in which there is a famine of truth. Even truth is not available. The absolute truth, gospel truth, you can't get it if you are not truthful person. So first you need to be truthful. And then the gospel truth would be known to you. That's why Peter was the first one to deliver the lecture or sermon in a new church. He will speak the truth and the foundation of the church. And then the other apostles then speak the gospel truth. No truth, no gospel truth. People who don't like truth, you can see with two naked eyes, they won't like the gospel truth. So you can't preach gospel to greedy people or dishonest people. No salt. Etc. are today in Kalyug and they create saltless people with no conscience. The rabbis, that the born blind person of John 9 confronted and asked them, do you want to be the disciple of Jesus? The people, the hypocrite messianic Jews who created Pope, remember the parable of the wine press and the husbandmen. The wine press is the temple and the husbandmen are the priests. And that's why Jesus was pointing finger at those priests who were there. That they could not do any other job than the job of a priest. So after the death of the apostle and other, then they took over the church of God. And they then created all the mess. They created men of dead letters, because our covenant with Jesus is of Holy Spirit and not of the books. So these Bible thumpers, so they are the legacy of those crook rabbis who killed Jesus on the cross. So now Rabbi, Brahman, Mullah, etc. are today in Kalyug and they create saltless people with no conscience. The rabbis, that the born blind person of John 9 confronted and asked them, do you want to be the disciple of Jesus? The hypocrite messianic Jews who created Pope and his Antichrist, stooges in the dog-collared licensed by the Antichrist organizations that made people deaf and dumb, like Jehovah's Witness. They have been given this written pamphlet. They are told that read these ones and only speak out from this one, not your own. Own, you have to be dumb, deaf and dumb. And that's what they are making. So, killed by deaf and dumb are killed by the Pope. Pope, if you are not deaf and dumb, you make your own decision or speech, which is not approved by the rabbi or the dog-collar priest in the name of Pope. Then you will be caught and burnt at stake, as they were burning people only at the stake. In Oxford 2, Thomas More, I think that somebody was killed there. So, twice born of the Holy Spirit, which is common sense. Oh dear, I get lost, you know. So I'm doing the number two, you know, which is a man, which is the mind, nafsani. The rabbi that the born blind person of John 9 confronted and asked them, do you want to be disciple of Jesus? The hypocrite messianic Jew, they were messianic Jew who created Pope and his Antichrist stooges in the dog collar licensed by the Antichrist organization. This is a Baptist church. Church of England is number one satanic church in among the all of them. That made people deaf and dumb. Be killed by the Pope. If you are not deaf and dumb, if you want to speak your own, Pope will kill you. Remember that in Kalyug, when the moral teachers become crooks, then God sends his very, very son, Christ Jesus, and his second coming, Satguru Nanak. Satguru means Christ. Nanak was not a guru. Guru means a rabbi. He was not a moral teacher, but a spiritual preacher. So that's how they confuse you. Second coming Satguru Nanak Devji of the Khatri tribe to preach the gospel truth through puzzles that only the twice born of the Holy Spirit, common sense, will understand. Why the men of dead letters, by the men dead in the letters, as they are in the universities and colleges today, who learn the dead letters from men and not the gospel truth buried in the parables. They can only teach you what is written, or they see but not perceive. Buried in the parables, that only the sons of God can explain. Only the tribal people of salt, conscience, would love to know gospel truth. If you do not have, there are two types of truth. One is the truth that you see with these two naked eyes. That during Holocaust, 4 million Jews died. That is the truth. Now the third eye of logical reasoning say, the person who were born, they were Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe. They were born, they will die. Not Jew. Jew is a spiritual self, inwardly, not outwardly. So not a single Jew died. And see how the people will jump at you. That is the typical example to find if you know any twice born people. They are all once born students of the Antichrist. So Khatri tried to preach the gospel truth through puzzles that only the tribal people of salt, conscience, would love to know the gospel truth. Typical puzzle of Christ, Arjan Devji, in this platter, in this plate, you know, lie three things. Satt, gospel, absolute truth. Santokh, contentment. And third is Vicharo. He say, let me know which is the third one. Vicharo means ponder over it. The third one you ponder, you have to find it. It is not mentioned, but it is to be found. Vicharo, find it out, the last thing, and that is mercy, in order to remain in the royal kingdom of God for eternal life. Without mercy in your heart, you cannot be part of God, because God is mercy. And there is no negative in God. It's all positive. The third spiritual state is called Budhi, wisdom, or the wisdom, wise men of the Holy Ghost, called Devta or angels. This yug called TRAETA YUG in Punjabi. TRAETA means three qualities. Possessing three religious qualities, which are Sharm, conscience, salt, family Sharm, you know, salt, truth, and contentment. Lacking the fourth quality, mercy. In this yug, prophets appear, and the Rabbinic Chair is created by Moses and Ram Chander. So prophet appear now, and then they carry on up to the Dark Age, when these prophets are not needed anymore. So that's why Luke 16 verse 16, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. So he was the last prophet among the chosen people. But prophet could be anyone where they have the scripture knowledge, and also they have scriptural knowledge. Then they can interpret the scripture in the light of the gospel. Without the light of gospel, you can't. So the fourth one, the last yug, is Satt Yug. Satt means absolute gospel truth that you get through logical reasoning. For example, they say in Holocaust, 4 million people died. That people saw with these two eyes, 4 million died. And yes, that's true, 4 million died. But it's not the absolute truth. The absolute truth is, people of Judah tribe, Benjamin, Levi tribe, they were born. They died during the Holocaust, led by their blind guide. That's why Jesus said, when a blind man, people are blind, they fall into the pit. And these pits are Holocaust, are sectarian riots. So the last yug is Satt Yug of the Christ of Chittavritti. That is Chittavritti. Whatever you desire, you get it. When most of the people possess all the four religious qualities, they are conscience, truthful, contented, and merciful. Most of the people are saints, and Jesus called this yug in Matthew 19. In the beginning, it was not so. that people were merciful, you know, so people, it was not shown as they were doing, cutting the throat of the people and other things. This is the beginning. Much more through my free lectures and videos, you can see them on the, my channel. So, I can carry on, you know, this is quite interesting, but it becomes boring for the people, you know. So, this is the gospel truth, and hope you appreciate it. And I close it down. Oh dear.